Hi, I'm Scott Noonan, the CEO of Audio Advice. This video is part of our series on the top 5 tips to improve your home theater video. This tip is about how to align your panels properly on your front projector. This only applies to systems using a front projection video display device, but I can tell you from experience, this one can make a really big difference in picture quality and is one of the best ways to improve your picture. Every projector with 3 panels should have a menu setting that will either be called panel alignment or pixel adjust. I'm assuming you've already adjusted the focus on your projector to be as clear as possible. If not, you'll want to do that first using the projector remote or the manual focus on your projector. You can actually check out one of our other tips to show you how to do it. You want to get your room as dark as possible and have your projector warmed up for at least 30 minutes before you start this process. The idea is there are red, green, and blue panels, and we want to get them to be in line with each other. Most projectors let you adjust 2 of the color panels to align with the 3rd. The owner's manual for your projector will tell you how to make the adjustments using the projector remote control. Projectors normally give you a choice of a general alignment first, then a much more detailed alignment of small areas on the panel. I find you will get the best results if you do the general alignment first, then look at the smaller areas and adjust any that look off. Usually the general one is called shift or hole, and the more detailed view is called grid or zone. Okay, so I'm using a Sony projector in our showroom to show you how to do this. I'm gonna pull up the menu on the Sony, and you'll see if you scroll down all the way down here to installation, the Sony has an option called panel alignment. We're gonna click that and go to the right. That's going to give us the ability to shift, and we will start with red. And I've intentionally taken the colors off now so it's easier for you to see, and I'm going to click shift. So I've got shift, red, and I'm going to click the adjust button here. When I click it, what you're going to see is that the red is too far to the left in here, and I've tried to overdo it so you can see it. You want to primarily focus on the center of the screen because that's where your eyes are most of the time. So when you're trying to align the panels, most of your eyes should be focused on the center. I would suggest closing your eyes for 10 to 20 seconds before looking at it. So I'm gonna hold the right button on the remote, and you'll see it's gonna move the horizontal, and I'm gonna get it back into alignment. And you'll see I'm moving. And I'm looking for where it just perfectly goes in to white. And you may wanna go past it. So I'm gonna go a little bit too far to the right. And then I realize it's too far and bring it back. And right about there, I look right on in the center. I then select that and go back. Now I want to change and adjust my blue. So I'm going to click on blue, go back down to adjust, and you'll see in the blue, I'm actually off as well. The blue is too high here. Hopefully you can see that. I've actually moved it in advance. So I'm going to bring the blue down, and you can see it's showing me the adjustment. And you can do this in, you know, whether it's a Sony or Epson or JVC. Bring it down. It's starting to look close. And about right there, I'm right on in the center. And I can look out at the edges here and see that the center's basically perfect. I might have just a tiny bit in the edges. Okay, so now what I'm gonna do is go up to the shift, and if I've got a few that are off, I'm gonna change that to zone. This is much more fine, and this is what you would do for your corners if you have them. So I'm gonna click adjust, and you'll see I can move this box and adjust anything. So if I look up here and I see, oh, I'm slightly off here, I can select that box and make my adjustment. In this case, I'm making it in blue, and I may bring it down just a tiny little bit right there, select it, and then I'm gonna go over here and look maybe at the corner over here where I see I'm slightly off, and maybe I'm gonna bring it down just a tiny bit there, and I think I've got just a little bit here. Anyways, you get the point. I would suggest working from left to right. Most of the time, you're only gonna hit a little bit in the corners. Now, if you find that once you've done this, because it's going to adjust inside, if it messes up anything closer to the center, what I'm going to suggest is that you go back, don't select this one anymore, and because if you mess up the center, you want to go back, change it back to reset it, change it back to shift, get it right for shift, and leave it there. So the most important thing is to have the center right. But this is basically how you do it. Once you've done it, you should see a huge improvement in terms of clarity and picture. It's a very simple thing to do. I hope this has made what can seem like a very technical process become super simple for you, and you'll see great improvements in your system. If you have any questions on this, leave a comment in YouTube or give us a call at audioadvice.com and we'll be happy to help you out. If you want more tips like this on how to improve your theater, click on the link in the description for our top 5 tips for improving your theater, audio, and video, and our top 7 most common mistakes to avoid. Also, if you like and subscribe, you'll get the latest home theater content as we roll it out. If you're updating your theater or building a new one, check out the home theater page at audioadvice.com, where we have our free home theater design tool, how-to videos, inspiration gallery, and home theater install videos. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.